Good morning again. I want to come to you on the day after we got some what might be perceived as discouraging news. Yesterday, our governor announced that schools would not reopen, that we would finish school online. And that might be discouraging, but I don't want it to discourage you. I want you to understand that they made the best decision they could make in trying times. No decision is easy. They did what they thought was best. When I first started riding a bicycle in 2006, I lived in Franklin County. There was a road in Franklin County called Coburn Mountain Road, and you can imagine it had a severe upgrade at one point, and it became the challenge of me as I began to learn to ride a bicycle on the road. Please know that I was significantly heavier than I am now. The first time I tried to ride up that road, I didn't make it all the way. I had to stop and rest and get off and walk around. I didn't let that discourage me. I let that be a challenge to me that I could do it the next time. I continued to ride. I continued to train a little bit. And just a couple of weeks later, I tried it again. This time I made it. And it was the best encouragement that I could get, that I could, in fact, conquer Coburn Mountain Road and get to the top of that hill. In the book of Philippians, we read a lot of encouraging words that often help us overcome our discouragement. One of them is found in chapter 4, verse 13. It says, I can do everything through Him who gives me strength. I just want to encourage you in these days when we're looking for some ways to be encouraged, to lean into God, lean into His strength, lean into what He can do through our lives. I also want to share with you that it's no time to give up. Please don't give up praying. Please continue to pray that God will do something supernatural in our country and around the world related to this virus, that we can see the end of it very quickly. It's very important that we come to a place in our society, in our country, where we can begin to meet in larger gatherings again. Even though the schools aren't going to gather, that doesn't mean that they've permanently shut the doors of the church and of restaurants and of businesses. It means we need the Lord to quickly act so that we can begin to gather again in larger groups so that we can have church in our buildings again. I know we're doing incredible things to bring church to you online and all kinds of things, but I want to be honest, I think we're missing something by not being able to gather in our churches. So don't give up. Please don't give up. Please continue to pray. Please continue to pray boldly, pray strongly that God will do something supernatural to end this virus and allow us to come back to some sense of normalcy in our life. Look, we're going to come through this and we're going to be better. We're going to be more aligned with God. We're going to be a lot of things spiritually. But I think we need to be able to sustain all things. We need to be wise, discerning, in order to find the best way forward. And I think the best way forward is for God to do something supernatural in our midst. And I want you to keep praying about that. Pray hard that God will do that. So, tune in Sunday to your church, to our church. We'll live stream at 8:30 and 11, a contemporary service at 8:30, a traditional service at 11. I'll be live. We'll have some other live elements that day. But I just want you to stay connected with God, stay connected with His strength, and allow Him to do all things through us who gives us strength. Have a great day, a great afternoon, and a weekend. Stay aligned with God in all things. Talk to you later.